On June 25, 2025, the Axiom-4 crew launched for a mission to the International Space Station and executed 60 scientific studies and activities sponsored by 31 countries across the globe. This private mission had four crew members from four different countries: Shabhashu Shukla from India, Swaboj Uznański-Wisniewski from Poland, Tibu Kapu from Hungary, and Peggy Whitson, the mission commander from the United States. There were some new activities or studies in this mission, but many were similar to studies already performed in previous space flights, albeit sponsored by different countries and companies. I will focus only on a few of them, thus offering insights into the future of accessible and sustainable space exploration. The first one falls under the category of studies performed in the past, but this time sponsored by a company in the United Arab Emirates. Bungie Holdings, a healthcare service provider, looks to demonstrate the accuracy of continuous glucose monitors for diabetic space travelers. This study highlights the attention that spaceflight draws from institutes and businesses worldwide, and as more companies look to provide the necessary tools and also the services to make space accessible to all kinds of people, we are also opening new economic growth opportunities here on Earth. Another psychological experiment that relates to studies run in previous space missions is the ISS Age Computing for Crew Readiness Demonstration by Buzz Allen, Axiom Space, and Aura. This study could benefit multiple industries here on Earth that rely heavily on skilled human performance. In space, this technology demonstration aims to assess the preparedness of astronauts and future space travelers to execute critical tasks. The goal is to eventually eliminate the need for continuous communication with Earth to complete critical tasks and activities during space flight. India sponsored several studies. Among them was a study called Sprouts. This study looks to assess the impact of spaceflight on six varieties of crop seeds, their germination and growth in space, and understand how crops might be grown in space for future exploration missions. Another study sponsored by India looks to study the growth rates, cellular responses, and biochemical activity in microgravity of cyanobacteria, which through the photosynthesis produces oxygen and therefore could be integrated into the spacecraft environmental control systems. Two independent studies, one sponsored by India and the other sponsored by the Polish space agency ENISA, studied algae as potential producers of oxygen for waste management, toxic compound decomposition, and viability as sustainable food and life support system for astronauts. Another interesting experiment investigated the revival, survival, and reproduction of tardigrades. These minuscule anthropoids, known also as water bears, are described as the toughest animals on Earth and have been in space studies since 2007. In this study, the Indian Institute of Science looks to identify molecular mechanisms of resilience, which have implications for understanding the limits of life in extreme environments like space or here on Earth. In this mission, ESA also conducted a related study using a tardigrade gene. This experiment tests yeast genetically modified with the tardigrade gene into its genome. Tests on Earth have linked this gene to the resistance of tardigrade yeast to the extreme environmental conditions. The results of these tests are essential in defining the feasibility of using such modified yeast in biofactories on Mars, the Moon, or during space travel. Another experiment performed by ESA and Poland is the LOPAR ISS test. This test is focused on data processing for space applications using the LOPAR data processing unit, designed originally for mini and micro satellites. This unit was installed on the Columbus module of the ISS to test AI algorithms directly in space. LOPAR will be part of the digital system in the ISS that researchers and institutions here on Earth can use to upload, test, and validate algorithms in real space conditions without requiring them to buy their hardware. Another interesting project sponsored by the Polish space agency ENISA is the effects of cosmic radiation on drug stability. The experiment included taking sample packages that would be stored in the ISS under different conditions for 1, 2, and 3 years, and then they will be brought back to Earth and compared to ground control samples to assess their space-based shelf life. If you want to learn about the full scientific studies and activities performed during this mission, visit the Axiom-4 website. I will provide a link in the comments, or you can also ask. Also, if you like the information in this video, please remember to subscribe or follow me.